A local area network, LAN, is a network that connects devices within a limited geographical area, like an office building or a campus. Securing the LAN is crucial to prevent unauthorized access, data breaches, and network disruptions. Here are some key aspects of LAN security. To establish a robust and secure LAN, local area network, it is essential to implement various best practices. Firstly, network segmentation using VLANs provides enhanced security by dividing the LAN into smaller, isolated segments. This approach limits the scope of potential attacks and prevents unauthorized lateral movement within the network. Secondly, strong access control policies should be enforced, with technologies like 802.1x authentication requiring user authentication before network access is granted. This ensures that only authorized devices can connect to the LAN, bolstering security. Deploying firewalls and intrusion prevention systems, IPS, is crucial for traffic control and real-time analysis of network data. Firewalls manage traffic flow between different network segments and the LAN and the internet, while IPS detects and blocks potentially malicious packets. Secure protocols play a vital role in protecting network data. Avoiding insecure protocols like Telnet, which transmit data in plain text, is essential. Instead, opt for secure protocols like SSH Secure Shell for remote management of network devices, as SSH encrypts data for secure communication. Lastly, regularly updating network devices' firmware and software with the latest security patches is crucial. Vendors frequently release updates to address known vulnerabilities and enhance overall network security. By adhering to these best practices, you can create a well-protected LAN environment, safeguarding your data and network from potential threats. Device hardening involves securing network devices to reduce their exposure to potential threats. Let's explore some important device hardening techniques. In this configuration process, we are securing the Cisco router's privileged exec mode and enabling password-based access for remote management. To begin, we use the enable secret command to set an encrypted password for privileged exec mode. This ensures that only authorized users with the correct password can access and make changes to the router's privileged commands. Next, we enter the VTY, Virtual Terminal Lines configuration mode, using the line VTY04 command. In this mode, we can configure settings related to remote management and access to the router. To enhance security, we set a password for VTY lines using the password command, ensuring that remote users must provide the correct password to access the router. We further enable password-based access to the VTY lines by using the login command. By following these steps, we establish robust security measures for the router, safeguarding privileged exec mode and enabling controlled and secure remote management through password-based access to the VTY lines. In this scenario, access control lists, ACLs, are employed to regulate network traffic by implementing specific rules. The example ACL is configured to allow traffic only from the host with the IP address 192.168.1.10. This means that any incoming data packets originating from this particular IP address will be permitted to access the network, while other traffic will be filtered or blocked. To apply this ACL to the incoming traffic on the Gigabit Ethernet 0/0 interface, the command IP access group 1 in is used. By associating ACL1 with the incoming traffic on this interface, the router enforces the specified rules, granting access to the IP address 192.168.1.10 while restricting other sources. This approach allows network administrators to exert granular control over network traffic, enhancing security and managing data flow effectively. By configuring ACLs, organizations can tailor access permissions to meet their specific needs and protect their network from unauthorized access or potential security threats. In this configuration example, we focus on enhancing the security of the device by disabling unnecessary services. By disabling these services, we effectively reduce the attack surface, minimizing potential entry points for malicious actors. The first service disabled is DHCP, Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, which automatically assigns IP addresses to devices connecting to the network. In some scenarios, DHCP might not be needed, and disabling it can prevent unauthorized devices from obtaining network addresses. Next, we disable CDP, Cisco Discovery Protocol, a proprietary protocol that allows Cisco devices to share information about themselves. While useful for network discovery and troubleshooting, Disabling CDP can prevent potential information leakage to unauthorized devices. Lastly, we disable the HTTP server functionality, which allows the device to be configured and managed through a web interface. By doing so, we eliminate the risk of unauthorized access through the web interface, as it is no longer available for potential attackers to exploit. By selectively disabling these unnecessary services, we proactively bolster the security of the device, reducing its exposure to potential vulnerabilities and strengthening the overall resilience of the network infrastructure. Port security is a vital feature in network switches that enhances network security by limiting the number of devices that can connect to a specific switch port. By controlling the number of allowed devices, port security prevents unauthorized access and potential security breaches. In this configuration example, we implement port security on a switch port using a series of commands. First, the switch port mode access command is used to set the port to access mode, ensuring that it functions as a regular user device connection point. Next, the switch port security command enables port security on the interface, activating the feature for this specific port. To further restrict the number of allowed devices, the command switch port security maximum 2 is used, limiting the port to only 2 connected devices based on their MAC addresses. This prevents excessive devices from being connected to the port and ensures a controlled and secure network environment. Lastly, we configure the switch port security violation shutdown command, which instructs the switch to shut down the port if a port security violation occurs. A violation can happen when an unauthorized device attempts to connect to the port, and this action immediately disables the port to prevent further unauthorized access. By implementing port security with these commands, network administrators can enhance network integrity, prevent unauthorized access, and maintain a secure and reliable network infrastructure. In addition to implementing robust security measures, continuous monitoring of the local area network, LAN, is essential for early threat detection and effective incident response. To achieve this, various monitoring techniques are employed. Firstly, regular log analysis is conducted, where network device logs are reviewed systematically to detect any unusual activities, potential security breaches, or configuration errors. Monitoring logs provides valuable insights into the network's health and security status. Secondly, Intrusion Detection System, IDS, and Intrusion Prevention System, IPS devices are strategically deployed within the network to continuously monitor and analyze network traffic. IDS detects and raises alerts on suspicious behavior, while IPS actively blocks malicious traffic, mitigating potential threats. Lastly, the implementation of Security Information and Event Management, SIEM, tools is utilized to centralize and correlate log data from multiple sources across the network. SIEM provides a comprehensive view of the network's security landscape and assists in identifying patterns or trends that may indicate potential threats or security vulnerabilities. By employing these monitoring techniques, network administrators can proactively identify and address security risks, ensuring the LAN remains resilient against potential threats and vulnerabilities. Timely detection and response are critical in maintaining a secure and reliable network environment. Securing the LAN and hardening network devices are crucial steps in building a robust and resilient network infrastructure. By following LAN security best practices and implementing device hardening techniques, you can significantly improve your network's security posture. Remember, security is an ongoing process that requires continuous monitoring, adaptation, and the implementation of new security measures as threats evolve. Stay curious and vigilant in your pursuit of knowledge and security expertise. We hope this video helped you on your journey towards becoming a cybersecurity expert. Remember to subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications so you never miss out on our latest content. And if you found our videos helpful, please give us a thumbs up and share them with your friends and colleagues. Don't forget to check out the links and description for our Anki flashcards and to donate to St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. Your support can make a real difference in the lives of those in need. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.